This is a walkthrough of the project and sprint retrospective template in Coda. You would use this template when you want to work with your team to reflect on ways to be more effective on the next sprint or project. When you first open the template, it's really just one section here called the retro template. And you can scroll down here and you'll see that you can add things like team members below team. And these are team members that have been added to the doc, so I can write something like Alan. I should see here. I can add other people that are part of this team. And these are all people that you've shared doc with in this section here when you hit share. Context is writing about the context of this retrospective. And the themes, these are themes that you as the meeting leader or scrum master, you can put these themes down based on what people have written into team highs and lows. So this is the team high and low section where people can add in what they felt good about and what they felt not so good about during the last sprint. So the way you can do this is by clicking on add your highs and lows, and a new row will show up here and you can start saying things like great teamwork, and things that might not have been so well might include things like too many last minute changes. If you want to delete all the dummy data from the template, you can just click on the clear dummy data button right there and it'll remove all the dummy data for you. The next part of the retrospective is what you should start, stop, and continue doing, a pretty common practice for retrospectives. So these are organized by these three categories, and in order to add your feedback, you click on the add your feedback button, click on what type of feedback you're giving. Let's say I want to start doing something, have more meetings, and then you'll see that it shows up here in the start doing section. Again, you can also clear this data here by clicking clear dummy data. But the last thing I want to show is sometimes you want to turn your retrospective feedback into action items. So let's say have more meetings as an action item I want to turn into. I can click on turn to AI and it'll automatically add it down here to my list of action items. And you can also manually add action items like this to do. And then assign an owner to the action item. Finally, this is a section in the doc, but if you want to duplicate this to a new section, you can say duplicate, and this might be called new retro. And now you have a brand new retrospective template to use for your team.